Hello viewers, welcome back. And in this tutorial, we will discuss the muscles of the anterior compartment of arm. So there are three muscles in the anterior compartment of arm. These are the coracobrachialis, the brachialis, and the biceps brachii muscle. All these three muscles of the anterior compartment of arm are innervated by the musculocutaneous nerve. And these three muscles can be remembered by a simple acronym BBC. So let's discuss each of these muscles individually. So the biceps brachii is this muscle of the anterior compartment of our arm. And it is the most superficial muscle of the anterior compartment of our arm. This muscle travels from the scapula superiorly to the proximal forearm inferiorly. The biceps brachii is known as a biarticular muscle because this muscle travels across two joints, the shoulder or the glenohumeral joint and the elbow joint. And this muscle has two heads of origin, the long head and the short head. And these two heads then originate from different anatomical structures on the scapula. So the short head of the biceps brachii originates from the coracoid process of the scapula. The coracoid process is this anterior projection which comes off the lateral angle of the scapula. And the long head of the biceps brachii originates from the supraglenoid tubercle. The supraglenoid tubercle is this tubercular structure on the superior facet of the glenoid fossa of the scapula. The long head of the biceps brachii, as you can see, runs underneath this ligament known as the transverse humeral ligament. So the long head of the biceps brachii is held in place by this ligament within this sulcus or groove known as the bicipital groove of humerus. And the bicipital groove of humerus is formed between the greater and lesser tubercles of the humerus. After origin, the two heads of the biceps brachii converge to form a single muscle belly, which then inserts through a single muscle tendon onto the radial tuberosity. And the radial tuberosity is this outgrowth on the proximal and medial aspect of the radius. And some areas of anatomical studies also suggest that the biceps brachii also inserts onto the bicipital aponeurosis. So the bicipital aponeurosis is this flat sheet of tendon which comes off the distal end of the tendon of insertion of the biceps brachii, and it provides strength and reinforcement to this anatomical area on the front of the elbow called the cubital fossa. And this bicipital aponeurosis provides protection to the important anatomical structures which are the brachial artery and the median nerve. In terms of its actions, the biceps brachii flexes our forearm at the elbow joint. And this muscle is also a very important and powerful supinator of our forearm. So as the biceps brachii crosses both the elbow and the shoulder joint, so this muscle also should exert some effect on the shoulder joint. And in most anatomical study areas, it is mentioned that this muscle flexes the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. Now, if we study a little about the nerve supply of the biceps brachii muscle, so this muscle is supplied by the musculocutaneous nerve. So the musculocutaneous nerve originates from the lateral cord of the brachial plexus, which is made up of the anterior rami of the C5, C6 and C7 cervical nerve roots. The biceps brachii muscle receives its arterial supply from the brachial artery. So So the brachial artery is a major blood vessel of our arm. And this artery lies deep to the biceps brachii muscle. The brachial artery begins as a continuation of the axillary artery. So as the axillary artery crosses the lower margin of the teres major muscle, it then continues off as the brachial artery. The second muscle of the anterior compartment of arm is the coracobrachialis muscle. So the coracobrachialis is this muscle of the anterior compartment of our arm. And it is one of those several muscles that connect the scapula to the humerus. This muscle lies just medial to the brachialis muscle and deep to the biceps brachii muscle. So as its name suggests, the coracobrachialis muscle originates from the coracoid process of the scapula. And after origin from the coracoid process of the scapula, the fibers of the coracobrachialis then run down inferolaterally to insert on the medial aspect of the humeral shaft, just at the level of the deltoid tuberosity. The coracobrachialis acts to produce movements at the glenohumeral joint. So one of its actions is the shoulder flexion, and through this action, it flexes the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. And this muscle can also weakly contribute to the shoulder adduction. And through this action, it adducts the arm at the glenohumeral joint. If we look at the nerve supply of the coracobrachialis muscle, so just like the other muscles of the anterior compartment of the arm, the coracobrachialis is supplied by the musculocutaneous nerve. So the musculocutaneous nerve runs deep to the biceps brachii muscle and just above the coracobrachialis and brachialis muscles to supply all of these three muscles of the anterior compartment of our arm. In terms of its blood supply, the coracobrachialis muscle is supplied by the brachial artery. And the third and last muscle of the anterior compartment of arm is the brachialis muscle. So the brachialis is this muscle of the anterior compartment of our arm. And this muscle lies just medial to the coracobrachialis and deep to the biceps brachii muscle. The brachialis is the strongest flexor of our forearm. And this muscle connects the distal arm to the forearm, as you can see. So if you look at the origin and insertion of the brachialis muscle, so this muscle originates from the anterior aspect of the distal humerus bone, just near to the insertion of the deltoid muscle. This muscle then inserts onto the ulnar tuberosity and the anteroinferior surface of the coronoid process of the ulna. So the coronoid process is this triangular prominence on the anterosuperior aspect of the ulna, while the ulnar tuberosity is this tubercular structure just distal to the coronoid process. If we study the actions performed by the brachialis muscle, so unlike the biceps brachii, which is a biarticular muscle and runs across both the shoulder and the elbow joints, the brachialis muscle runs just across the elbow joint and is a pure flexor of the forearm at the elbow joint. If you look at the nerve supply of the brachialis muscle, so just like the other muscles of the anterior compartment of our arm, the brachialis is supplied by the musculocutaneous nerve. In some people, the brachialis muscle receives a dual innervation, with the lateral fibers of this muscle innervated by the radial nerve. The brachialis muscle receives its arterial supply from three arteries: the brachial artery, the superior ulnar collateral artery, and the radial recurrent artery. The brachial artery begins as a continuation of the axillary artery. So as the axillary artery crosses the lower margin of the teres major muscle, it then continues off as the brachial artery. The superior ulnar collateral artery arises from the brachial artery, and after arising from the brachial artery, this artery descends down to anastomose with the posterior ulnar recurrent artery. And the posterior ulnar recurrent artery arises from the ulnar artery. The radial recurrent artery arises from the radial artery. And after arising from the radial artery, it ascends back to anastomose with the radial collateral artery. Taking you to a posterior view, so you can see that the radial collateral artery arises from the profunda brachii artery, which is also called the deep brachial artery. And the profunda brachii artery then arises from the brachial artery. So this was a tutorial on the muscles of the anterior compartment of arm. Hope you like this tutorial. Thank you so much.